Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Christchurch for this celebration of 90 years of the choirs of Christchurch Greenwich. We are confident you will appreciate the opportunity offered by such an organisation for character building and fellowship, as well as for musical training and service to Christchurch. Thus ran a portion of the wording drafted by Claude Means in 1934 as he set about putting together a new choir consisting of men and boys. 90 years on, over countless generations, we have together built upon the foundation of that vision. Hundreds of children have been shaped by the discipline of regular rehearsal and teamwork. Their spiritual lives, as well as the lives of the adults alongside them, have been deeply formed through the routine of choral worship. They have been shaped by music, and as ministers of the church, they in turn have used the gift of music to shape others in times of joy, sorrow, thanksgiving, repentance, and celebration. And it's the celebration that is right at the heart of this evening's event. Showcasing six of our seven choirs, we have crafted a concert program that showcases the breadth and depth of repertoire unique to each choir. After hearing the ensembles in different formations, the choirs come together for a grand conclusion. Parry's "Hear My Words, Ye People." The text is a confident assertion of the everlasting promises of Almighty God. The music showcases a semi-chorus, which includes RSCM Gold and Silver Award medalists, as well as two lengthy solos sung by senior choristers, and a rousing finale in which our youngest choir, the St. Nicholas Choir, adds icing to the cake. The organ plays a major role, and in what is a tour de force for the organist, it provides a kaleidoscopic backdrop of colour. Before we begin, I'd like to thank everyone who made this concert possible. In particular, Joanne Booknight for designing the programme, Charlotte Gage for music administration, and Christina Hamill for the reception that follows downstairs in the parish hall. I'd also like to thank Elizabeth Fitz and all at Community Concerts of Greenwich for concert production and front of house. Guest conductor James O'Donnell for a continued creative partnership with the Institute of Sacred Music at Yale. And Sarah Harris for the infectious enthusiasm and educational expertise that she brings to the leadership of the St. Nicholas Choir. Special thanks goes to Dr. Philip Moore for his 15-year association with the music program at Christchurch Greenwich. Not only has this, without a doubt, been one of the most professionally rewarding relationships of my career, it has also enriched music at Christchurch in so many ways, both tangible and intangible. We all owe Philip a huge debt of gratitude. Enormous thanks are also due to my colleague and Associate Director of Music, Jonathan Vaughan. The fact that the choirs are in such a healthy state, bouncing back from a worldwide pandemic with even greater vitality than before, owes much to his dedication, musical excellence, and careful stewardship. I know I speak for all the choirs when I say that we count ourselves fortunate indeed to have Jonathan Vaughan on the organ bench. And finally, I'd like to thank our musical friends, our financial supporters, and of course, our unsung heroes, choir parents, old and new. This is truly a team effort, and we couldn't have done it without your gifts of time, talent, and treasure. Not to mention the thousands of really enjoyable trips up and down the post road. It is clear that you do indeed appreciate the opportunity offered by such an organisation for character building and stewardship, as well as for musical training and service. And so I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Happy 90th birthday, Christchurch Choirs.
Thank you. life to